Hi there, everybody. Jason back again with a little bit of familiar territory. We're going a hands-on video this time, and we're back in the living room. Basically, the Nintendo Direct happened this morning, and I kind of wanted to take a look at and share with everyone the new update features. So I've got my 3DS XL here, our new 3DS XL, and basically what it's telling me is that it's Street Pass update weekend, and I actually haven't done any of the updating. And I'm actually going to do everything that I have to do, right now, here for everybody. So let's go into the Street Pass, here and see what actually happens. I'm wondering if it's actually going to prompt me for an update here, or if there's anything else that I have to do. So I'm actually kind of excited. I didn't expect, like, an update like this to happen to the Street Pass, but then again, I mean, it kind of makes sense. 3DS is getting older, and with a new system coming out, and with the failure of, you know, the way that, or with the way that the Wii U has been going, everything sort of seems to be heading towards the 3DS as being like the system that they're going to support the most. New stock is available. Oh, I've got to turn off the 3D. Camera can't actually see that. So let's see here. Should be a thing for updates. Check for updates. And I'm actually a big fan of Street Pass. I really like it. It's a kind of a neat way to actually exchange information back and forth between players without actually even having to talk to anybody or... Oh, it says an update is available for content that you have previously downloaded. I want to update. It says you won't be able to acquire later updates on DLC for this content until you perform this update. So let's do that right quick. But yeah, big fan of the 3DS Street Pass. And I think the biggest limitation here was that you could only Street Pass with 10 people, and then you'd have to, like, clear it out and do it over again. But now with the ability to actually do 100 people, it's actually kind of nice. Like, I'm actually, like, thinking about carrying this with me more often just for the fact that I don't have to necessarily check it as often. And with Pokemon Sun and Moon coming out, I'll have this with me more frequently. So it'll be even more reason, because hopefully more people will be playing, and there'll be more people to meet and see. And I'm kind of excited about that. But I just put that down there for just a second. So the main thing to keep in mind is that they've introduced a couple other things. So they've got Quick Plaza, which I guess is a nice quick way to get through all of your Street Pass Plaza events, as well as play games in a nice quick manner. It sort of just moves everything at a nice fast pace. Then you have 5 new games that are coming out, and of course they're not free, but there is a deal, I guess. When you download one of the other ones for free, then you have the option of getting the other 4 at a discounted price, I believe. I saw, like, a slot car one, I saw, like, a stock exchange prediction one, there was a, what was it, it was sort of like a ninja cannon one, I don't know, like, I only saw this morning, and I've kind of forgotten what the names of those games were, but we're going to kind of get into it. Like, this is actually, like, we're actually just going to do everything. Like, right here, we're going to do it live. And my 3DS Street Pass is, like, the most current update one, aside from this. Like, I have all of the games, and the games are so-so. I liked the Ghost House one. I'm a big fan of the Street Pass puzzles. I kind of wish that they would do more stuff with that. The fishing one was kind of so-so. I liked the little side-scrolling space adventure shooter one. That was really cool. And the zombie one is neat too, but I feel like sometimes those games, like, the only reason why I don't necessarily play them that often or make it an active point to carry the 3DS around with me more often is just because they require a lot of time to actually go through. And when it comes to, like, the Street Pass, like, when it was just Find Me and the puzzles, it was super easy. It didn't take very long. And but now, like, when you have like all of those, and I've removed like some of them from my menu just because I just didn't want to play them anymore. I just had to make some changes to make it go faster. All right, so let's see. It's gonna restart. Oh, my lovely pink and yellow hair. And honestly, every time that they kind of do stuff like this, it kind of brings me back into the 3DS a little bit more. Because I'll play it. Like, I love playing the Badge Academy or the Badge, like, arcade. Let's see here. Got a few street passes. Got Jack. Oh! 100 birthdays. And like I said, I'm doing this live. Nice to meet you. Mii Maker, Max, and I've met him before. Playing Super Mario Bros. Deluxe. I'm gonna rate him fantastic. And then we've got Jake. This is actually one of the guys that I work with. Alright, so let's go back inside. I've got my lovely KK Slider hat on. Let's see, welcome. We've got big news. Street Pass Mii Plaza just had a makeover. On top of the games that are already available, there's a brand new set of games. There are new, quick-to-play games you can get, but wait, there's more! You can choose to receive either Slot Car Rivals or Market Crashers. Absolutely free of charge, that's right, you choose. And I do want to learn more right now, so we'll go in-depth with this. It says, talk to the Rabbit to learn more about the new Plaza games. Alright, so let's find Monsieur Rabbit. Okay, so we got Mii Trek, Ninja Launcher, Feed Mii, Market Crashers, and Slot Car Rivals. So I'm actually more excited about this one, so we're gonna go Slot Car Rivals. I've got something to tell you! It's about Slot Car Rivals. You can pick up one of these games and get it for free. Would you like to hear about Slot Car Rivals? Sure thing! It's a Street Pass Mii Plaza game, and you can buy it with your Nintendo eShop funds. Sounds like the other games, right? But just like Quick Plaza, you can jump right in with no delay. In Slot Car Rivals, you can take control of a tiny hot rod. Trick it out with exactly how you want, and then race it against the people you encounter via Street Pass. Zoom through the ranks, claim the title of world champion. So you want to know more? I'm here to help. Tell me more. You got it. By the way, Jason, you ever heard of slot cars? Actually, I have. Oh, really? I should have guessed. Get this, in Slot Car Rivals, the controls are just like real slot car racing. So there's only one button. The A button. Simple, huh? That's actually kind of cool. Basically, it's like you have your A button. It would only work better if you had like analog type controls, like maybe if you use the thumbstick, because when you actually play slot cars, and I have a video on my channel about slot car racing set, it's more like an actual trigger, and the harder you pull your trigger, the more speed that the actual slot car is going to get. So that's probably my only complaint right now. If you want the authentic experience of index finger control, you can set it up to use the R button instead. What I'm saying is, Slot Car Rivals is all about speed and the thrill of racing. The more Street Pass hits, the more rivals you have, and the better you'll be able to customize your slot car. With the help of hobby shop owner Nico Fire, you'll hit the track. Is your engine all revved up? Then set your sights on the World Championship! You can customize your slot car any way you want. Whether it comes to body style, the parts you want to use, their size and position, the color of the exterior, you can create the car of your dreams. But that's not all. You can unlock special cars too. That one looks like it's from Ridge Racer. And, well, I say cars. They come in all sorts of shapes and sizes. So, is the racetrack calling to you? Yeah, I want it. Okay, let's get you set up then. Please wait. If any sort of information comes up that's personal, I'll just sort of blur out the screen for a second while I'm dealing with it. But, excuse me. Like I said, I'm going to do this all as real time as I possibly can. It says rated E for the ESRB. All right, so I've got no balance, but it's free anyway, so I'm going to download it. All right, download will commence shortly. Depending on how fast these are, I'll probably just fast forward through these bits. but thankfully these things are pretty darn small. We might even go in depth into some of the games today too, if not all of them, because I am certainly curious. It's like, okay. And that's it, download complete. I really appreciate your patience. I hope you enjoy your purchase. Alright, so why don't we actually check this out? I'll turn up the volume a little bit. I can now play Slot Car Rivals. Also, here's a present for you. The Raceway hat. And one more present. Slot Car Rivals Balloon. I was gonna say, please don't change my hat. I like my hat just the way that it is. Oh, wait. Before I get into that, you've been a great customer. I mean, wow, just look at all of these games. So what do you think? Do you have any games that you want to move to the vault? Not right now. Whenever you want to visit the vault, just select this icon on the plaza. You can check out the vault anytime you like. I'm kind of wondering, should I go for the other games? Yeah, let's just get the setup done first. Alright, hi there, Jason O. Now that you're here, you can buy Market Crashers. Tell me more. It's a Street Pass Mii Plaza game, and you can buy it with your Nintendo eShop funds. Sounds like the other games, right? But just like the Quick Plaza, you can jump right into it with no delay. In Market Crashers, you'll become a pro trader, buying and selling shares. Can you beat the financial mastermind, Bennett Worthington? with help from the people that you meet via Street Pass, you'll have a chance. Use their tips to make hot trades and piles of cash. So, want to know more? Or find out the price? Price, please. You got it. Okay, let me connect to the internet. It should just take a moment to look up the information. Alright, so we're going to actually get set up to do everything else, I think. At least I believe that's what's going on right now. Market Crashers cost $2.99. Do I want to buy it? Thank you very much. Oh, I almost forgot. Right now, you can buy the third batch of Extra Plaza games all at once. Here we go. This is what I was looking for. Because we're offering special bundle deals right now, do you want to learn more about the bundles? Yes, please. Special bundle deal is pretty neat. Lets you buy all four of these games at once. Each game gives you new ways to play with folks meet via Street Pass. Would you like me to tell you more? Please do. Feed Me tests the limits of your cooking skill. You'll become a chef in a restaurant in the world of Find Me. Heroes you meet via Street Pass will bring ingredients to your kitchen. It'll be your job to make the food they crave. Become a heroic chef and cook food fit for legends. Ninja Launcher answers the question, what happens when you shoot a ninja from a cannon? I like that, it's cute. Armed with nothing but your wits, climb into the cannon and prepare for battle. The people you meet via Street Pass will give you weapons and armor. Fly from the ninjutsu cannon, power up, and exterminate the demon army. In Mii Trek, you'll travel far and wide. Sort of sounds like another Mii, like Find Mii thing. As a globe-trotting archaeologist chasing ancient treasure. Using the real-life step counts of the people you meet via Street Pass, You'll journey to the heart of the jungles and ancient ruins. Always one step closer to unraveling shocking ancient secrets. Alright, if you buy each game separately, here's what each one costs. So $2.99 for each one, so a total of $12, right? 3 times 4, 12, yeah. Bundle 3 costs $8.99, so $9 or $12. So you save $3, one game for free, basically. Do you want to buy Bundle 3 for $8.99? Yes, please. You got it. Thanks very much. Alright, I'm going to take a second. I'm probably going to fast forward and blur this a little bit as I actually get this all set up. Okay, we're back. So, altogether, what it looks like here is that the first one takes up 200 blocks, and then this one takes, like, all the rest of them, like, the last four take up 776. And then, so it's $8.99, and tax for me ends up being about 50 cents, so $9.49 for everything. So, not incredibly terrible at all. Plus, I mean, there are games that are super cheap and super easy to play, so whatever, I'll pay for it. That way you can see. Alright, so I'm probably gonna fast forward through this too. Alright, and getting back to it, download is complete. So, looks like we're gonna get into some of these games. I really appreciate your patience, and thank you so much for your patronage too. I hope you enjoy your purchase. Alright, so there's Market Crashers. I'm probably gonna get a hat and a balloon for each one. At least that's what it seems like so far. Because of course they want to give you something extra special for purchasing new games. Alright, we've got Feed Me. I'm actually kind of excited for that one too, and jumbo beef hat and a Feed Me balloon. Alright, and then we've got what's that, Ninja Cannon? Or Ninja Launcher? Ninja Cannon, Ninjutsu Cannon Hat, and the Ninja Launcher Balloon. That's actually kind of lucky that I've got, like, at least a few people that I street pass with, so that way I can actually play these games right away and find out what they're all about. Alright, and then finally, we have Mii Trek. So we've got a Trek hat and a balloon. Okay, so it says, you've been a great customer. I mean, wow, just look at all these games. So what do you think? Do you have any games you want to move to the vault? Not right now. I'm going to leave them all here. Check them out anytime I like. Alright, so let's get into it. So looking at here, I'm guessing that this is the button to access the Quick Plaza? Welcome to the new Quicker Plaza. It's a streamlined version of the classic plaza you know and love. You can greet Mii visitors at the gate or hop into games fast. It's even quicker for users with the new Nintendo 3DS systems. Met hundreds of people via StreetPass? It'll help with that too. You can switch between the two plazas by touching the icon on the touchscreen. So, this guy right down here. Okay, so basically, let's actually just take it slow. Say bye! Okay, anyway, let's jump into it. First off, I think we're gonna do Mii Trek. Because I kinda wanna do the street pass, the slot cars last. It's a good shot of me. Alright, Mii Trek. Welcome to Mii Trek. Explore exotic locations using step count of people you meet via Street Pass. Ready to get exploring? Ah, the spirit of adventure. Let's get going. Items and locations depicted in this game are fictional representations. Humans have explored this planet for thousands of years, yet there's still so much to discover. Freaking reflection. A map has fallen into the hands of a certain archaeologist. You! Adventure is calling, and this archaeologist shall answer. The intrepid adventurer sets off into the mysterious jungle. Drawn by ancient mysteries, intrepid explorer Jason O arrives in the jungle. Ah, Jason! I see your sense of adventure has awoken. My name is Sir Harry? I accidentally pushed a button. Now, as we all know, it's dangerous to go alone. Thanks, Zelda. Explorers, assemble. Oh, holy crap. Oh, I was like, I haven't got that many steps on the people that I have today. Alright, so he's gathered some fellow explorers for my party today. Next time you'll need actual Street Pass people. We'll explore using the step count from your fellow explorers. When an explorer's step count hits zero, they'll have to bow out. Now, let's get after that treasure. Explorers, let's sally forth! I just realized that this video could be incredibly long. I'm guessing that it's probably going to be at least half an hour, if not longer than that. Chapter... blank. The Hunt for Beaksley's Treasure. Alright, so first, take a look at the jungle map. Which is down here. Alright, I see a single treasure lies hidden somewhere in this locale. I'm guessing that... how do they say, like, a single treasure? The flashing marks you see indicate locations of interest. And if you get lost out there, remember to check your map. You can zoom in on the map by pushing X. Okay. Alright, let's get exploring. Alright, so it says find some treasure. Alright, so it says moderate trek. It's like... oh my, we've encountered a classic fork in the road. Be fearless, look carefully at the paths that lie ahead and make your decision. Puddles take a lot of steps. Okay, so I'm heading towards a puddle right now. Wait, I can go back and I can go to the moderate trek. So, full map. Okay, I'm actually gonna go with the short trek. It's like, I found a stone chest. It's empty. Alright, so we've got... oh, okay, so basically I have to go back to what I was doing anyway. So let's go with the moderate trek. Alright, so choose a path with A. I'm gonna go with, let's see, moderate trek and moderate trek. I'm heading towards that stone. This rock is blocking the path. Path is blocked. You made short work of the rock. Alright, let's see here. Short trek, moderate trek, short trek. I'm gonna take the middle road. Oh, you've hit a dead end. Okay, so basically you keep on going until you run out of steps is what I'm guessing. Oh, I should have known that'd be a dead end. So let's go short trek. Another dead end? Okay, well that sucks. So we're gonna make a moderate trek back. And then we're gonna take the moderate trek up. I've acquired an ancient compass. Mysterious compass, the arrow points the way to ancient treasures. Okay, so it's actually guiding me towards treasure now. Alright, this is as far as you can go. Get some rest. Alright, so it sort of gives you a recap of what you've done. Tells you how many steps you've actually taken. And let's see here. So, back to title. Alright, so that's it. I'm going to save my explorers for the next time. We're just going to quickly go through and basically do all of their little tutorial missions. So let's go Ninja Launcher. Either that, or maybe I'll save those for the quick pass and see if it really kind of affects anything. Ninja Launcher. Grab scrolls from fellow ninjas to strike down the demon invaders. Welcome to Ninja Launcher. In this game, you'll launch yourself from cannons to defeat demon foes. Do you accept the challenge? Yep. Concealed by shadows, the Jason O Ninja Clan protects this land from all threats. An evil demon army has arisen, and the land is now at risk. The demons attack towns, towns fall, fear and chaos spread in the army's wake. Sensei, it is time. As heir to Jason O Ninja's Ninja Clan, you must save this land. I have just the tool to save the townsfolk from the foul demon's onslaught. A cannon. Our clan's treasure, passed down for generations, ninjutsu cannon. I, Shinobu, your loyal apprentice, will take care of the launching. And to you, Sensei, goes the honorable role of the cannonball. It's like, what? Okay, Sensei, your clothes will catch fire in the cannon. That's why you disrobed. Okay, just a second. There's going to be a little break. I have to reset my filming so I don't time out while it's actually doing something. Okay, and let's keep going. Legends say our ancestors faced the demons completely unarmed. You, as the proud heir, surely wish to bravely, huh? You'd rather wear clothes? Then, Sensei, I will aid you in battle simply by taking all these priceless equipment scrolls that have been in our clan since it was formed, and attaching them to all these equally as priceless antique kites. Now all you must do is catch the scrolls in midair. Sounds easy, Sensei. This time, let's enlist the help of some wandering ninja, your allies. As your apprentice, I'll take care of aiming the ninjutsu cannon. You must grab the scrolls by positioning allies, line them up, and fly. Switch the ninja you're moving by pressing L and R. Position them true. Sensei, don't rush in. Maximize the scrolls you grab with some practice shots. Launch a scarecrow first to ensure the scrolls line up. Press A to practice. Okay. Wait. Okay, so as you can see there, there's a dotted line that actually shows the position as to which, like, where your shot will actually take you. So I've positioned all of my people on the line with their kites, and I'm gonna shoot a test shot. Okay, so that's it. I grabbed all the scrolls, and if you master these techniques, none can defend. Sensei, it is time. The real battle now begins. Now you must press Y. Alright, so A is a test shot. Y is my actual real one. Okay, got a ninja suit, a kunai, and a ninja hood. Perfect, a critical strike. What a learning curve. I knew you'd catch on quickly. I'd expect no less. If we can gather more allies via Street Pass, the demons are toast. Alright, that's it. That's actually a nice, quick little game. It says down here, like, do battle, gather allies using your Street Pass coins, records, and all that sort of stuff. So let's exit out of here and then start up the next one, which I think is Feed Me. This one might actually be, like, super cute. Alright, so Feed Me. Cook for your heroes you meet via Street Pass. Oh, what a lovely little restaurant. I want to go there. Let's see here. The meals you cook will give them strength to fight on. Are you ready to play? Ready. Time to go out there and make culinary history. Oh, how quaint. I actually do really kind of want to go to a nice old restaurant like that. Oh, adorable. Chef Jason, there you are. I'm Crispin. And I'm an assistant chef. Good to meet you. Seems like it's set in, like, England. Monsters kidnapped our ruler. Everyone's freaking out. Some have even run off, including all of our chefs. But you're here. What a relief. This is no easy job. We have to cook for these heroes. They always stop to eat a meal on their way to save our ruler. If you give it your all, the heroes can too. Your food will give the heroes the strength they need to fight. Time's wasting. You better get cooking. It'd be kind of cool if the events of what happened here, like, affects, like, Find Me. Alright, this is the kitchen. It's where we combine ingredients to cook them up. And then down here I've got what looks like a list of ingredients. There are 12 basic kinds of ingredients, meat, vegetables, and other stuff. Heroes stop by here before heading out on quests. I might actually have to show both of these screens to actually do this properly. And they bring their own ingredients. Normally we'd use those, but today I've got to see what you're made of, so we'll use ingredients I prepared. Try combining these ingredients to make our signature dish, beef and rice casserole. It's not hard, just select the ingredients you want to use. Oh, let's get out a nice stylus. And then select Create to cook. Alright, so begin cooking. I think we probably need three ingredients, so... Okay, so basically it's giving you, like, a couple, like, red herrings. Oh, wait. It's got recipe. Don't quite know it just yet. So I'm gonna guess beef, rice, and the tomato. Actually, it doesn't even look like I need to use the stylus. Cooking complete. Beef and rice casserole, meal rating, four stars. Alright, new dish added to the recipe book. Recipe complete. There you go, an artisan beef and rice casserole. So this is a lot like, what, Order Up, or a couple other games that I've seen recently where basically you, you cook sort of meals and then hand them off to the customers. Let's see. First time you make a dish, it'll be added to your recipe book. Handy! If you make an artisan dish, the recipe is completed. You'll see all the ingredients you can use. It gets even better. Do a really good job, and some recipes turn into jumbo portions. Study the recipe book, and you'll be able to cook up some real gourmet stuff. Oh, and don't forget, I stashed your leftover ingredients in the fridge. Any ingredients stored in the fridge can be used later on. Got all that? Then it's time to open up shop. So it looks like you get ingredients to cook as you actually meet Street Pass people? Alright, so let's... We're gonna move on. I've got another plan. And that's a good basic idea of what the game is. And again, that one's nice and quick too. Just gotta hold on to this. So let's go see Market Crashers. Alright, Market Crashers. Amass a fortune trading stocks with a little advice from your StreetPass Plaza advisors. Alright, welcome to Market Trashers. Crashers. Let's see. Buy and sell stocks with the advice of the Mii characters you've met via StreetPass and see how much in-game money you can earn. Are you ready to play? Let's get trading. Loving the excitement? Let's get you set up to trade. It's like a real stock exchange. Because this is all how it really works, right? Welcome to the world-famous Mii Plaza Stock Exchange. These are the big leagues, kid. People come here from all over to trade shares. But you've got a look about you that says this is your first time trading. I'm right, aren't I? I knew it. Lucky for you, I teach a tutorial. All right, nothing down at the bottom. I'll give you a step-by-step instructions free of charge. You'll have the hang of it by the end, and you'll get your first taste of the day trading life. Before I get ahead of myself, day trading is buying and selling shares in a single day. And my name is Wallace Street. Oh my god, but my friends call me Wally. What's your name? Or would you rather I keep calling you Kid? Jason, I'll be sure to remember it, Kid. Something tells me you're gonna make it big. So what do you say? Wanna check out the day trade tutorial, or would you rather dive in head first? Teach me, Mr. Street. You got it! Never lose that enthusiasm, kid. No matter how hard the market crashes, now watch and learn. Alright, this is the day trading screen. Let's go sort of both screens again. Alright, this is the day trading screen where all your day trading will take place. The basic principle of trading stocks is you gotta buy low and sell high. What you see here is a stock chart. Use it to make predictions about whether the stock prices will increase or go up. But predicting every outcome by yourself can be tricky, even for a pro like me. That's where the analysts come in. Excuse me, one second. Alright, I've invited some analysts who owed me a favor to help out with this tutorial. But help isn't always free around here, kid. After this, you'll need your own analysts. Alright, so I've got three little people to help me. Let's start by looking at how the stock price will fluctuate throughout the day. Alright, trading open. Do you see that? One of the analysts predict that the price will drop. Now let's see how it changes. You're about to see a day trading in action. The stock price went down. I knew we could trust that analyst. This is your chance. Push A or touch the buy button 5 times to buy 5 shares. Alright. Yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Now you got 5 shares. What a rush! Now we wait for the price to rise, like the financial hunters that came before us. Oh, look at that sharp rise. Is there a more beautiful sight? Your total profits went up to 31,500 grand, or G, or whatever. The profit loss indicator shows how much you'll earn or lose by selling at that moment. Like I've been saying, buy low and sell high. You'll maximize your gains. Now press Y or attach the sell button 5 times to sell your shares. Okay. You just made 31,500 gold. Pure profit, kid. Trading that good gives me the chills. Now, keep an eye on the price just a little bit longer. Another drop. Quick, buy another 5 shares. Okay, and now we wait. Oh, the ebb and flow of the stock market. All right, performance up. Huh? A special news report. Breaking news always leads to big change. It really took off. We got lucky this time, kid, because news can bring stock up or down. Now's your chance to land a critical strike. Sell, sell, sell. Okay. All right, you made 43,000 gold profit. Are you exhausted as me? Since this was just a tutorial, the function paused so you could buy and sell. But time, tide, and finances wait for no one. In the real world, my mouth is getting dry. Prices fluctuate constantly. Trading closed. All right, so now the moment of truth. Let's see how you did. All right. Value of currently held stock. Profit loss from trading. Profit. It's an average of 3,386 earned every second. Wish I could say that. All right, so session chart, and my rank was competent trader. You made 74,500. Nice work. I'm proud to call you kid. That's it for class. Next time you trade, it'll be the real deal, kid. Good luck. All right. Hope you learned a lot from the tutorial, kid, because you're in it now. You have all the tools you need to really make a name for yourself. What was it again? Too slow, kid. Time is money. Just remember, the most important thing about trading, buy low, sell high. If you remember nothing else about day trading, remember that. And if you ever want to take my day trade tutorial class again, head over to the trading floor. There's nothing worse than a bad investment, so I offer the class 24 hours a day. Now don't get too teary-eyed, but I got you a gift to celebrate your first visit to the stock exchange. See, your first step towards becoming a financial fat cat. Got a trader badge. Aw, that's adorable. Oh, got some breaking news. Master trader Bennett Worthington's assets now equal 10 billion gold. His assets are worth 10 billion? He hasn't even taken my class. I bet we find out that he's, like, cheating. What? Of course you want 10 billion gold in assets, too. Who doesn't? But you can't just make that much overnight, kid. He only makes it look easy. Let's start off with a more reasonable goal. How does 10 million sound? Millions may not be as cool as billions, but you'll learn the ups and downs of the market. Alright, so that was it for Market Crashers. I'm going to pause the recording real quick. And we're going to go back and do the other. All right, so give me just 1 second. All right, so we're back with Slot Car Rivals. Race against Street Pass Rivals to become the world champion of the slot car circuit. Outrun your rivals in the high-octane slot car excitement. There can be only one slot car world champion. Will it be you? And I am ready to start. My engines are revving. That's the spirit. Let's get started. I kind of wanted to save this one for last because it's actually the one that I'm actually most excited about. Hey buddy, nice to meet you. We host slot car races in here. Here in the store, you can race the rivals you meet via Straight Pass. I'm Nico Fire, the shop manager. You can ask me anything about slot cars. I'm kind of an expert. The bows are caught in your eye, huh? That, my friend, is a world champion of slot car racing. They call him Iceman. It looks exactly like you. He also happens to be my big bro. That would explain it. Pretty cool, right? So it's Jason, oh, huh? I'll get everything ready at the counter for you. Do you want me to show you the ropes before you jump into your first race? Let's do it. Great! You can borrow this car for now. It's the shop model, but it runs just fine. Starter custom car. A gift from Nico. Alright, let's head over to the racetrack. Alright, tutorial. Got my car. Alright, slot cars race along a slot on a track. Our tracks have 11 slots, so we can have some big races. Controlling one is super easy, just push A and off it goes. Oh, down here is your little slot car. Hold A down to keep the gauge full. Let go and you'll slow down. Okay, to start, try holding the button down as your car rounds the first corner. I'll start the countdown. Okay, that makes sense. Did I get you? Sorry, I wanted to see firsthand the trickiest part of racing. If you crash, it'll take a little time to get back on the track, so slowing down here is crucial. You can actually use corners to your advantage. I'll explain how. Each corner will be graded as excellent or cool depending on how well you handle it. Once you master this technique, you'll be hitting excellent corners every time. First, you want to hit top speed. Hi guys, unfortunately the footage that was actually supposed to be here got corrupted and I can't recover it. So basically I'm just going to finish off and replace it now. So this is going to go up as a reshoot and I'll probably end up taking the other one down. Regardless, what I was talking about was the slot car racing, and I was basically giving a demonstration of how the slot car works. And basically it's like you go around a track and then there's sections that are basically marked as white and red, and those are the corners that you have to basically stop accelerating on and then start accelerating as soon as you're exiting it to to get a boost on. I moved my foot and scared my cat. But it's a lot of fun, and when I actually played it a little bit later, there's actually different tracks to race on, so it's not just that basic track, which is also very cool. Let me just round it off by just going over my thoughts, because really that's all the video at the end was. It was basically just a little mini review of each of the games. And let's just start off with, let's see here, where am I at on here? I'm going to use this as sort of a little guide to help me. So let's start off with Mii Trek. So Mii Trek is basically another sort of find me. It relies on you walking around and then running into people via street paths that have also been walking around. The more people you meet, the more steps they've taken, the further you can go and the more you can explore, which is really kind of cool. I like it. It's pretty simple. It's definitely one of the longer games that's in here, so not that bad at all. I like the Find Me, by the way, and it's kind of cool to have an excuse to do another one of those. Next one is Ninja Launcher. Ninja Launcher is a strategy-type game where you launch a person out of a cannon in attempt to collect all of the items that are along the path that you're actually being fired. It's kind of like a puzzle strategy game. Not very involved, but pretty okay too. Probably like the second longest out of all of them. And then after that we have Feed Me. It is a game that sort of revolves around your adventurers that are going out to fight in Find Me. And as far as I can see, they bring you ingredients and you use those ingredients to cook their food. And basically you have to cook the right thing, otherwise they're unhappy. If you cook the wrong thing, you know, you don't get the points or whatever credit that you get. I need to play a little bit more of it to sort of get into it. But it seems sort of like Order Up or Diner Dash or something like that, where basically you can get customers, they tell you what they want, and you try to make it. Pretty simple. Again, not necessarily like a super quick game, but it's still pretty fun. I like that one. Fourth one is Market Crashers. That one's stock market based. Basically, depending on how many people that you street pass, depends on how many analysts you have to help you guess whether it's going to go up or down in the market. You have to be quick and then use predictions and luck to earn a bunch of money. As far as I can see, it looks like it's a pretty quick game to get through. And then the last one, which is the one that I was super excited for, was Slot Car Rivals. Slot Car Rivals is a slot car racing game in which you race around track with anybody that you street past. It looks like you can race up to 10 people at a time, not including you. So 11 people races around the racetrack. Lots of fun. Controls are very tight. It's just one button. A button, and that's it. You can actually switch it to the right trigger if you like that sort of like gun action like I'd been talking about in my previous video. But it plays very well. Definitely my favorite. Probably like the better one out of all of them. And if you only get like one of the games, getting that one for free is pretty darn fantastic. Even paying $3 for it isn't really that bad. The last feature that I wanted to talk about was the Quick Plaza. So Quick Plaza, it's not exactly what I thought, and this is basically what I'm talking about. Like, this is Quick Plaza right here. It sort of shows all of your characters and anybody that you've street passed sort of walking towards the bottom of the screen. Excuse me. And then it shows basically all of your games right here. And it allows you basically to, at a touch, go into each of those games and start playing them. It doesn't make them any faster. It doesn't hold down the speed up button in any of the games. Basically, it makes meeting characters, collecting messages and everything like that much faster. But that's about it. It's a cool way to actually arrange it, and I like it. I appreciate it. But it doesn't do exactly what I thought it would. Either way, that's basically it. If you have any questions about these games, please let me know. I'm going to spend some time playing them. It's going to actually give me a good reason to carry my 3DS with me a lot more now, especially for the fact that Mii Trek uses like actual steps to get things. So I'm actually excited to carry this with me. I kind of want to see if I can fill up my plaza with 100 people. And I want to see like how that works, especially with the Quick Pass, the Quick Plaza, rather. So I'm excited to see that. I didn't expect this update. Like, it really was a surprise. And honestly, I'm happy that they did it. The increase to 100 people on the plaza, more games, especially for the price of $9, not really that bad. Even with the freebie games, it's really good. So, but yeah, leave a comment down below. Ask any questions if you'd like. Tell me if you got the games. Tell me which one you like. And then, you know, I've also got a poll at the beginning. I kind of like to see people's opinion to see, like, sort of what everyone sort of thinks about each of the things. So, but yeah, we'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.